So COVID-19 and the current pandemic that was announced yesterday by the World Health Organization is an interesting moment in the evolution of this planet. It's not the first time this has happened, because those of us who are old enough will remember SARS and the impact of SARS on our national economies and local economies. Now, the interesting thing about SARS is that if you search for the academic papers on SARS, you will see one paper on the economic impacts of SARS and lots of papers on the medical aspects of SARS. Now, COVID-19 is going to be radically different because the economic impacts are going to be much more extreme. And we could argue they're going to take a number of different forms. First, there's local adjustment. So meetings of individuals that are being banned in Denmark. So any meetings over 100 will be illegal and will not be able to take place. So various restaurants and bars that have capacities of 100 have been closed for a short period. So immediate responses linked to hospitality and restaurants. Now, all of that's unfortunate because our high street has been moving away from retail towards a high street of experiences. All of those experiences involve face-to-face contact. So all of those new traders are going to suffer a significant local, rapid and immediate impact on cash flow. Other forms of adjustment involve global supply chains. So over the last 25 years, our products have become much more distributed and dispersed in terms of their components. So the average Apple phone contains 3,500 components. Those components come from 7 different countries. Any interruption of supply chains means that Apple has a major problem in delivering its new phones and products to its consumers distributed across the world. What we're going to see is a localization of supply chains. There's a beginning of a debate on right-shoring. What is the right location for a product to be produced? The right location minimizes carbon, but also will maximize national security. So there's a little company in Limerick that employs 38 people. Well, it employed 38 people 3 weeks ago. It now employs 70 people. It's one of the only European manufacturers of face masks for theatres, and it certainly found itself occupying a little niche. But that company will continue to grow. The third thing we're seeing is interesting rapid adjustments to do with environmental pollution. So COVID-19, one of the big benefits is that the pollution streams that are coming out of China and Italy, Germany and the United Kingdom are being tempered for a time as people are adjusting the ways in which they're using cities and living in cities and using national space. Now that adjustment may be a short-term adjustment, or it may result in long-term change that might have major impacts on climate change. So the issue with COVID-19 is watch this space. Individual behavior is changing, will have to change. Government behavior will have to change and companies will have to change. And all of this is going to be, it will unfold in the ways in which products, services, and people interact with one another over the next 5 or 6 years.